Life in the Arctic is quiet, peaceful. The landscape breathtaking, ever-changing. Despite the freezing cold temperatures, this wintry wonderland is home to over 4 million people, numerous fishes, mammals, and birds. The smallest of the Earth's 5 major oceans, the Arctic is almost twice the size of Australia, covering 14 million square kilometers. Polar regions are faced with emerging challenges. Climate change is affecting the entire globe, but it's especially pronounced at the poles. The temperature in the Arctic Circle is rising twice as fast as anywhere else on the planet, leading to melting glaciers. While receding ice opens new shipping lanes and commercial opportunities, it also increases maritime traffic. According to an Arctic Council report, the number of ships entering the Arctic grew by 25% between 2013 and 2019. Conversely, climate change causes weather anomalies, such as unusual cold spells in autumn. This was the case in late 2021, when the Arctic sea ice extent grew unexpectedly faster than in recent years. Water that was free turned to ice, leading to various ship groundings in the remote northern sea route. In a rapidly changing and largely uncharted Arctic, increased maritime traffic presents many challenges, mainly due to how remote it is. Maritime operators and crew need to remain vigilant. In the event of ship grounding or collision, search and rescue crews must fight rough seas and freezing temperatures to timely evacuate the ship. But that's not the only challenge. Relevant authorities need to mitigate risks such as oil spills. Precise localization is therefore crucial, as time is of the essence. Boats and vessels of all sizes can now rely on Galileo-enabled EPIRBs to accurately establish their location when activated, and thus benefit from the return link feature. When a Galileo EPIRB is activated, the Galileo satellites pick up the distress signal and transmit it to 3 ground stations strategically deployed across Europe, called Miolutz. By using the relayed data from the Galileo satellites, the Miolutz are able to calculate the location of the distress source with an average location error under 5 kilometers. Once the location is determined, it is transmitted to different mission control centers, MCCs, around the world that coordinate the rescue operations. After the responsible MCC has determined the location of the distress alert, the Galileo return link is activated. The user then receives via the Galileo satellites a confirmation message that their position is located by the system and the responsible search and rescue authorities have been alerted. The Galileo return link service increases survival rates by giving an important psychological boost to people in distress. It is estimated by COSPAS SARSAT that the International Search and Rescue System, with the contribution of the Galileo Search and Rescue Service, saves more than 2,000 lives a year. Galileo brings added value to Arctic search and rescue operations because it offers greater coverage in higher latitudes, and thus more robust performance. But there's more. Search and rescue operations can be further aided by Copernicus, the EU's Earth Observation Programme. The Copernicus Marine Service provides authorities and rescue centres with valuable data such as wave height, current direction, as well as sea ice concentration, including drift ice and solid ice forecasts. It can also detect icebergs. Vessels ranging from container ships, cruise liners to fishing trawlers can navigate safely across our Nordic seas thanks to Galileo and EGNOS, up to the 72nd degree north. While mapping agencies benefit from the EU's satellite navigation systems to develop precise nautical charts and maps. The EU space program's contribution to the Arctic Circle goes beyond search and rescue and safe maritime navigation, benefiting the environment. Accurate navigation offered by Galileo and EGNOS leads to route optimization and therefore curbed emissions and less fuel consumption, helping maritime operators comply with the International Maritime Organization, GHG, strategy. Moreover, optical and synthetic aperture radar images by Copernicus are used for oil spill detection. When combined with accurate positioning from Galileo, they assist authorities to reach the incident site easily and thus mitigate the negative impacts of oil spills and fight illegal fishing. Protecting the Arctic and the ecosystems related to it are an important part of the EU Green Deal. With an integrated EU space program in place, Europe has the capacity to better understand the challenges the Arctic Circle is confronted with, shape new mitigating policies, and develop the necessary tools to fight climate change.